Hello, welcome back to my channel. In the last episode, I shared with you the experience of my quarantine in Vienna Hotel in Chengqing, Zhuhai. Now I'm finally out and free to move around in the city. Most people call me uncle in Singapore. However, people here in China call me 帅哥, which means handsome man. Haha, since I'm in China now, I will call myself 帅哥 Patrick, aka SG Patrick. In this episode, I will do a quick explanation of how China's health codes work to fight against the pandemic. Then I will bring you to a few interesting places in the city, followed by showing you some good food here. After a short stay in Zhuhai, my next destination will be a much more exciting city, Shanghai. Join me. It is now time to leave the quarantine hotel. I'm now heading to my Airbnb apartment in Zhuhai. This building in front here is the Hengqin border building to Macau. Further down the road, you can see the Zhuhai Tower and the Macau Tower further away on the right. Zhuhai Tower is the tallest building in the city and is ranked 35th on the list of tallest buildings in China. It houses the St. Regis, Zhuhai Hotel and Office Tower. This is the Intercontinental Hotel building cluster which opened just a few months before the pandemic. The location is right next to the Gongbei border to Macau, and the hotel has an infinity pool that overlooks the Hong Kong-Macau-Zhuhai Bridge. This elegant seashell-shaped building is the Zhuhai Opera House. I will do a more detailed introduction of this place in later part of this video. Zhuhai is a modern city in southern Guangdong province, transformed into one of China's first special economic zones in 1980. Today, the city is known for golf resorts, theme parks, and islands off the Pearl River Delta. As you can see, the city has a lot of greenery and it has very nice bicycle trails along most of the major roads. Before we start exploring the city, let me first give you an introduction of the health code system in China. If you understand Chinese, you can quite easily find the quarantine requirements online for each province. Sometimes the requirements can be slightly different for different cities within the same province. There is always a list of districts classified as high-risk zone and another list for medium-risk zones. There are three colors for the health codes. Red means that you either just entered China or have been in the high-risk zone within the last 14 days. You should be serving your quarantine with a red code. Yellow code means that you might be serving your 7-day health monitor or you have been inside a medium risk zone. You need to complete your 7-day health monitor and do a PCR test to return your code back to green. Green code of course means that you are safe to travel anywhere within China without restrictions. The health codes can be generated by the mini programs on either WeChat or Alipay. The programs for different provinces are different and vary in design. This one for Guangdong even includes your recent PCR test result and your vaccination record. You need to know the name of the code for the province you are at and search its respective mini program. When you move to a different province, you might be asked to show the health code for that province. For example, this one is for Anhui province. You can choose to register for a new health code or just port over the data from your original province. For some critical areas such as hospital or large factory, you might be asked for travel history code in addition to your health code. This travel history code is generated based on the location history of your mobile number. This is the view from my Airbnb apartment. This night view with the rainbow color lighting from the Opera House is amazing. The row of lights along the left side of the horizon is the Hong Kong Zhuhai Macau Bridge. There is a very nice beach right across the road downstairs. It is along the famous Lover's Road of the city. If you are interested to know the exact location of this place or need information about this Airbnb apartment, you can leave me a note at the comment section below. Look at this beautiful sunrise. There is a seaside bicycle trail along the road that can take you all the way to the Zhuhai Opera House and the town center. There is also a newly built boardwalk along the beach if you prefer not to get any sand in your shoes. There are some fishermen casting their nets here. This is a very traditional fishing method. And then they sell their catch right along the roadside in the neighborhood. Looks like there is a sailboat event going on, or this could be a training class. After about 5 minutes bicycle ride, I'm now approaching the Zhuhai Opera House. Along the way, there is a floating seafood restaurant called the Yuefang. This is similar to the Jumbo Seafood restaurant in Hong Kong. Unfortunately, it looks like it's not operating anymore. I think it must have closed down due to the lack of tourists because of the pandemic. Okay, we are reaching the two seashell structures soon. This is the entrance of an island called Yeli. The whole island is a park. Wait, there is something colorful moving in front. Let's see what's going on there. Ah, a group of ladies in red skirts are doing some sort of performance here. They are even equipped with a drone for filming. Zhuhai Opera House, aka Zhuhai Grand Theatre, is a landmark building of the city. It was designed by architect Chen Kesi. It held its first performances in January 2017. The Opera House comprises a 1,550-seat concert hall and a 500-seat theatre, located on an island at Xiangzhou close to Macau and Hong Kong. The performance venues are each housed within architecturally striking shell-shaped forms, which at 90 and 60 meters tall are visible from afar. In the following summer after the completion of the Opera House, Zhuhai was hit by two huge typhoons which caused some damage and flooding into its facilities. After that, they learned to reinforce the waterfront with lots of concrete blocks, as you can see here. This has become nice fishing spots for the locals. Okay, let's move on to the next attraction. Meanwhile, enjoy the nice scenic bicycle ride with me. This next destination here is called Xiangshan Lake Park. With a total area of around 2.7 km square, it is the largest lake park in Zhuhai. I spent more than 2 hours and still could not cover the whole park. The lake is used as a reservoir to store water for the city. The park was built in three phases, and phase 3 was completed just recently in December 2020. It is now one of the main landmark attractions for Zhuhai. I will condense my footage to a few minutes so that you can take a quick look at the park. Look at this interesting heart-shaped pet house. I think they are going to put some animals here. As you can see, there are very nice walkways or boardwalks
built along the landscape of the hill. Look, there's a longan tree here. It is so pleasant to take a walk in this park in a hot summer day like today. The nice boardwalks, the water, the bridges, the lotus ponds, and the fresh air. No wonder this place has become a popular destination for both the locals and the tourists. If you like my video or find it useful, please smash the like button and subscribe to my channel so that you won't miss out my future videos. If you would like me to cover something that I missed out in my videos, you are welcome to leave your comments below. Wow, there is a pair of black swans here. They seem quite skinny compared to those in Europe. As Zhuhai is prone to typhoon, they have to secure the slopes with some reinforcement structures. Here are some stores where we can buy some drinks and snacks. As you can see, the landscaping is very nicely done. This building here seems to be some exhibition or meeting area. This public toilet is very interesting.
The wall is made of oyster shells. Zhuhai, being a coastal city, is very famous for its oyster farms.
Even the inside of the toilet is very nicely built. Here is a mango tree.
I'm quite impressed by how well built this garden is, and it is free of charge. Some wild ducks wandering around. Ah, there's another black swan here. The kids must be having a lot of fun. The whole garden is very clean, and I don't see any rubbish around.
Okay, that's it for the tour of this beautiful park today. Let's move on to the next place. Stay with me. This is another beautiful sunny day. I happened to go past this place called Fuhuali. It is not one of my main targets, so I will just do a quick walk around. This is a modern retail development consisting of several 2-3 story low-rise buildings. There are quite a few branded retail stores and nice restaurants here. It could be a nice place to spend a weekend evening if you have time. I'm going to take this sharing bicycle to bring you to the next amazing place. Follow me. This place is called the Banzhanshan Pedestrian Tunnel. It is shared by both pedestrians and bicycles. This tunnel took 2 years to build and was just opened recently in June 2020. With the length of about 1.23 km, it is the longest pedestrian tunnel in China. The pedestrian walkway is about 3.5 meters wide, and the bike path is about 4.5 meters wide. On the ceiling, there is a 3D painting of the sky with balloons and birds. Somewhere at the middle of the tunnel, there is a roughly 50 meter long projected screen showing some cartoon. The whole tunnel is fully covered with mobile signal, and you won't get cut off of your data like most other tunnels elsewhere. I feel very cooling inside here, although it is not air conditioned. Okay, we are now reaching the end of the tunnel. Let's move on to the next place. Now, let me take you to the next amazing place. It's not open yet. We need to wait a few more minutes. Look at this impressive walkway. We'll go up there later. Let's take a walk around the area first. This place is right next to the Zhuhai Museum, which is very nice building. But I'm not a museum person, so I have never gone inside before. This is the back of the museum. Okay, there's a queue forming now. Let's go. The entry is free. The queue here is for us to show our health code and our travel code. I need my phone for this, so we'll have to turn off the camera for a while. Okay, we are in now. This new development is called Xiangshan Yundao. As you can see on the map, they are building a very long walkway system that links all the various existing trails in the mountains shown here. Xiangshan is the name of the mountain area, and the literal translation of Yundao means walkway in the cloud. Currently, only a very small fraction of the project is open for public preview. They are targeting to open the whole trail by end of the year 2021, or latest by 2022. I will be very interested to come back and walk the completed trail when it's fully open. This is the view from the viewing platform. On the right here is the Zhuhai Museum, where we came from. Down there, I believe, will be a shopping mall with plenty of parking lots for visitors. On the other side, we can see the Opera House and an excellent view of the city. Over here, you can see more walkways being built on the other side of the mountain. Okay, for now, only this small part of the walkway is open for public. I think enough sightseeing. Let me show you some food in Zhuhai next. I was talking to my friend who works in Zhuhai. He's taking me out for lunch in his newly bought Tesla. There happens to be an Xpeng in front. It is a China-made electric car. This is a traditional Cantonese dim sum restaurant. The dim sum here is excellent. These are very typical dim sum dishes. Their specialty is this crispy rice roll with shrimp, and is the one I like the most. Yangming Mall in Zhuhai is another place with lots of good restaurants. I'm on the way to meet another friend for dinner. Look at this. No one needs to wear masks here, because there has been zero local COVID case here for a long time.
playground here.
This restaurant is famous for its live seafood and porridge. You can come to the live seafood area to pick your menu. If you enjoy my video, don't forget to smash the like button and subscribe to my channel. Feel free to leave a comment below about what you like and don't like about what I show. They put the ingredients of the porridge below the steam plate before we start steaming the seafood. The juice of the seafood will drip down to the porridge later. Thank you for staying till this part of my video. You can easily find the details about the restaurants I show here by searching their names online. Now the porridge is ready. Okay, it's time to move on to the next place. I will be flying to the magical metropolis, Shanghai. See you there in my next video.